Puloma, you are live.
Okay, thank you. Good morning, my dear viewers. Hope you all are doing well. Today, this is your host, Puloma Nandi from Global Education and Training Institute. Welcome you all in this session of Disruptive Education Movement, which is an initiative of GETI. That is Global Education and Training Institute. And as you know, in this moment of disruptive education, we invite all speakers, great education leaders, thinkers to come on this platform and share their views, share their ideas, a lot of knowledge and experience so that we as a community and fraternity can mutually get benefited. And so in this series, today we have speaker with us, Mrs. Anita Nanda. Mrs. Anita Nanda is the founder principal of Lala Jagat Narayan DAV School, and she is acting as a principal for last 27 years. She has given many presentations in abroad as well as in her own country. Mrs. Anita have also submitted many papers in the field of education and was awarded for her innovations in the field of education. In 2009, she was awarded by Sri G.P. Chopra, President DAV Management, and was also awarded for her outstanding teaching methods by S. Chand Groups. She was awarded for excellent work in the field of education by Sri Balramji Das Tandon, Governor of Chhattisgarh. Other than this, she has also been awarded for the work of Needy Women by Children and Women Welfare Society. So I, on behalf of Global Education and Training Institute, take the privilege and honor to welcome Madam Mrs. Anita Nanda in today's session. Madam, you are most welcome, and you are going to say on the topic on instructional methodologies and management in this crisis. So I request my viewers to stay tuned, watch this whole session, and if you have any questions, any queries, please post your questions in the comment section so that Madam can get back to you with the replies. Thank you so much, Madam, for your time. Now it's over to you, Madam. Thank you.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Good afternoon, Poloma ma'am. First of all, I express my gratitude to Mrs. Sunita Gandhi ma'am for giving me the opportunity to share my views on this instructional management during COVID-19. That is, we all know that our pedagogical ways need to be changed due to this COVID-19. Online classes are going on and the child is not present in front of us in the classroom. So the need is that we must ponder over these questions, that what should be our instructional management, how it can be managed, and why should we change it. So we need to ponder over these questions very seriously. As the child is not present in front of us in the classroom, he is at home and we need to catch him up. So we need to change our pedagogical ways also. And to change those pedagogical ways, we have to think that these pedagogical ways should not be examination oriented. These should be competency based. As CBSE has also suggested in its circular number 34 dated 14th May that there should be competency based education. So we as teaching fraternity, we have to think that what should be done, that there should be good learning outcome and there should be close connection between the learning outcome, the pedagogical ways and the modes of assessment. So we all need to design all these things again. It means we have to design our instructional material and pedagogical ways in such a way that we are able to make the child do the things. So The competency-based education is the need of the hour, and we must understand that this competency is the development of ability. We have to keep the child engaged actively at home. We have to enhance his interest level so that the child, he is able to develop his abilities. So ability is a little bit broader term than skill, because a skill is a specified learning ability. And in ability, the child first gets the knowledge, then he gets mastery on the skill, and after that, he becomes competent. He develops his ability, and we also need to bring desirable behavioral changes in him also, because a child should have positive attitude also, and we have to design our learning pedagogical ways in such a way that we are developing positive attitude in a child along with our instructions. So we have to focus on all these things. That's because if a child is skillful, he knows how to do the things, but he doesn't have the desired behavior, then that kind of person doesn't become successful in his life. So this is not only essential that we know the skills, but this is also very essential that how do we behave. So our attitude must be positive. So we have all to bring all these changes in the child through our pedagogical ways. So this is what competency level ability is. And now the thing is that why should we change it? We all know that the present scenario, it is the demand of the present scenario. The child is sitting at home, and I personally feel that this time has given ample of time to ponder over that there should always be competency based pedagogical ways, as we say that we have to make the child do. So before designing the pedagogy for that particular concept, the teacher has to set the learning outcome. So what should be the learning outcome? The teacher must think that it should be a specific statement which will be instructions of the things. And she to design to achieve outcome.
The modes of assessment also. The teacher has to share all his learning outcome and modes of assessment with the child, and she has to share that success criteria with the child in the form of rubrics, so that the child must come to know that getting these instructions or after getting through the instruction material, he has to do this and he will be assessed in this way. And if he will perform well on these parameters, only then he will be able to develop his ability. The outcome should be that string three that learning outcome design specific demand achievable and time. It means whatever the teacher, suppose the teacher is particular skill to be developed, so the teacher must be clear that what does she want the child to do. Then she should have clear idea that what type of assessment she has to design to develop that particular skill in a child. So all these things are very closely connected to it. So then that when she find a particular line learning out for a particular, this thing must be very much clear that she has to measure those outcome also. She has to design her board in such a manner that she is able to measure those learning outcome. Then she must see that whatever pedagogical ways she is designing, those are being designed to achieve the aim that she will be able to make the child do that particular thing.
So whatever she is designing, it should be relevant. It should not be irrelevant. And for the time, I would say that the teacher must think that during these days, the teacher can be a little bit lenient because the parents, she can contact the parents also for this purpose. That the teachers, the parents, they can provide that technology, that technological tools to the child, because sometimes the parents have only one phone and they have two children. So teacher must contact the parents also for purpose that at what time they will provide these technological tools to the child to see the instructional material and prepare his own video. So these are the things which the teacher has to keep in mind while designing his pedagogical ways. And that's why we say that there is close connection between these learning outcome and these pedagogical ways and modes of assessment also. So this is what I say, that this learning pedagogy should be experiential learning based, it should be activity based, it should be project based. And the teacher must come keep this thing in mind. She should keep patience, and the rubric she is sharing with the child, that is, she is sharing for the improvement of the child. This process is for the improvement of the child. It is not to grade child and to label the child that he is intelligent or he is performing in a poor way. So this all this process is designed to improve the child, and the teacher, when she'll be sharing the performance of the child in the form of the rubrics, the child will come to know that where he is improving well, where he needs improvement, and then again with the help of the teacher he can improve those weak areas. So I will be sharing orally to the and the repeating. Pedagogical way. Let's suppose is Taj Mahal sharing with you what should be her. So the teacher is first designing. It will be primary and importance of she will design that the child will be able to describe the architectural diagram of Taj Mahal. And next, the child will be able to use appropriate vocabulary to describe the Taj Mahal. Next, the child will be able to explain why it is called the seventh wonder of the world and what are other wonders of the world. Teacher will also hear her video telling the child to make a building. The teacher will also share why people from all part of the world come to visit Taj Mahal. So these are the outcomes she will set, and then she has also to design the pedagogy to keep in mind the learning outcome she has set. She will prepare her own video on this topic, wherein she will be describing everything about the history and about the importance of the place. And then she can also harness the technology to provide the link of the video to the child. And she can also discuss with the child to develop the aesthetic sense in a child so that he may learn to admire the beautiful things, that why the people from all over the world come to visit this place. So accordingly, she will also design the assessment sheet to achieve these learning outcomes. The teacher can, that she will, in the assessment sheet, the teacher can tell the child to speak for 5 minutes about the historical place. The teacher will be asking the child to make his own video after seeing her video to describe the place in 5 minutes. And then she can share these rubrics with the child, that for content, the child will get 3 marks. For fluency, he will get 2 marks. For the use of correct language, the child will get 3 marks. And for confidence, he will get 2 marks. So this is how she can share the things with the child, that this is the assessment sheet. You have to speak for 5 minutes, and on these parameters you will be assessed. And then the next assessment sheet she can prepare, that she can ask the child to take the world map and locate the other wonders of the world. Then she can give another worksheet to the child, that the child has to write the description about Taj Mahal using the appropriate vocabulary which the teacher has shared with the child in our own video in 100 words. Then she can also ask the child to locate the location of Taj Mahal on India's map. Then another worksheet she can given, where she can integrate artwork also, and she can also tell the child to draw a sketch of Taj Mahal and color it properly. So this is how teachers can develop the skills and the abilities of a child, and to develop the aesthetic sense in a child, that is to develop the life skill in a child, the teacher can give the topic that why do people from all over the world like to visit Taj Mahal, wherein the child will speak his views and he will also write his views. So this is how the teacher, I'm sharing one sample of the pedagogical method. This is an instructional methodology which the teacher can design during this lockdown period due to COVID-19, when the child is not present in front of us. So this is how, Pulluma ma'am, I have shared the things with you. And if you have any question, now you can ask me. Hello? Hello? Hello?
बीच में
हेलो हेलो मैडम अनीता मैडम Hello, Anita madam, are you there?
Hello?
Anita madam, are you there?
Hello.
I'm here. Hanji, you
okay,
were able
Anita
to hear
madam.
me?
Anita madam.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, you I think there
Hello,
was some
Anita
network
madam, are you there?
disconnect. Yeah,
And
you can please
you couldn't
carry on.
hear me.
Anita madam, are you there?
I should
I'm
carry on
here.
From start.
Anji,
yeah, yeah,
you
yeah. Where you
madam,
left, you carry on.
Anita madam.
Okay.
Yeah, you. I think
up to which you were able to hear me?
Hello. Yeah,
Hello.
You were talking about that how with the rubrics you can tell them to talk about Taj Mahal. You know about Taj
Okay.
Mahal.
Learning
They
outcome
can.
you had no. Okay,
You
I
can
will
just
share
start
once
from there.
again.
Yeah, please.
Okay. I will share once again that while designing the learning outcome, the teacher should be very, very specific. That statement should be very, very specific, and the pedagogical ways she is designing, those are being designed to achieve those learning outcomes, which means that what the child will do after getting those pedagogical material, getting that pedagogical material from the teacher. So suppose she has to teach about the historical place Taj Mahal. So the first learning outcome she will be setting for the child will be that she will be able to define the history and importance of Taj Mahal. And for that, she will make her self-made video on this topic, and wherein she will be describing the history, as well as she will be providing the appropriate vocabulary to the child, and she will be sharing the importance of that place with the child. And to harness the technology, she will also give the link from internet to the child. So then the next point which the teacher can tell the child to do is that she will be telling the child to describe the architectural designs of Taj Mahal. For that, she can also provide a link from internet, or she can share her own self-made video with the child. She set the learning outcome that she able to use appropriate way to describe the Taj Mahal. Child will be able to explain that it is why it is called the center, and what the also be telling the child to draw a sketch of the monument Taj Mahal, describing the different parts of this great monument. So accordingly, she will be setting her pedagogy and her assessment sheet. And in her assessment sheet, what the first task which she will be giving to the child, and before giving a task, she will be sharing the success criteria with the child. That suppose she tells the child to speak on 5 minutes about the history about this place, and she will be telling that the child has to make his own video describing the importance of this place. Then she will be sharing that the child will be assessed for content for 3 marks, for the fluency for 2 marks, and if the child will be using correct language, he will be given 2 marks, and for confidence level, he will be given 2 marks. Now the child knows that on which areas he has to work. He will watch them carefully, and then he will share the things with the teacher that how he can improve his performance in this task. So this is how these things will be interlinked together, and the teacher, she has also to develop the life skills in a child also. That is, the child must know to admire the beauty of this place, and he should know that why the people visit these beautiful and great buildings, because these give pleasure to our mind and give happiness to us. So he would come to know that why do people from all over the world visit Taj Mahal. So all these things the teacher would share with the child in the form of self-made videos or from the link from internet. And I think if the teacher will be sharing all this learning outcome before imparting his instructions to him, and he will be sharing the success criteria with the child before teaching him or before giving him the instructional material, the child will be able to develop his abilities. And so one thing should be kept in mind that all these pedagogical ways are to improve the child. And these are entirely different from the traditional ways of teaching, because in the traditional ways of teaching were evaluation based, where the child was only graded. But here, there is a scope of improvement for the child, and he can be guided that his which area is weak, weak area. That the teacher has to keep hands, and he has to on that one and turns to the child, and the instruction is sending, and parents must provide the technological tool to the child, and she must also hear the problems of the if the parents say that they are available only in the evening, then time slot can enhance for that particular child. So this is what I say, that the task she is giving to the child, it should be simple. And again I say that the whole task should be smart, it should be specific, it should be measurable, it should be achievable, it should be relevant, and it should be time bound. And again I say that she is writing the specifically is writing it to assessment through her which she is sharing with the child, and make it achievable modes. And whatever she is designing, it will be relevant, and it should be according to the level of the child. Because of the technological fault, I could not share my videos with you. My children, they send very meaningful videos to me. Just as I'm telling you that I had given them the topic, it was UKG class, and the students were given instructions on what are animals. So what my teacher did, she told a child to collect leaves from the nearby surrounding. She prepared her own video that how these water animals from the leaves can be prepared. And then the students prepare very beautiful video by preparing those water animals, and they share their things with me. And they sent that video back to the teacher and to me. And we were very much happy to see the performance that the child, we have been able to develop the abilities in a child, that now he knows the content, he has understanding about the content, because all this we are doing to raise the level of the child. For merely rote learning, we are taking him to create the things. So to create the things, first he has to know the things. Then he has to understand the things, and then he use that knowledge and analyze that knowledge, evaluate that knowledge, and create his own things. So the teacher must give simple tasks and simple projects to the students and tell him to use those things which are easily available at home. So any other question, Pullama? Hello? Hello?
Yeah. Yeah, madam, can you hear me now?
I'm Hello. Able to hear you.
As of now, I have not seen any questions posted in the comment section. But I'm sure that the way you have actually described the entire thing, all the viewers probably got a very clear idea. Though there was some unstable network was a little bit unstable, yeah. And it happens, technical glitches are there, But I'm sure after this, if anyone needs to really post, my viewers can just post it here, and so that madam can get back to you. But you have mentioned it and described it so well. You know, you have very rightly, as I said, it was really so interesting. I was listening to the entire session very carefully. And you did speak about how the instructional management, it's actually a management these days, even instructional.
Yeah.
I mean, people do not understand how important is instruction. Like classroom management, instructional management is also equally important. And as rightly said, as a teacher, one should be telling these instructions very clearly before the task. It's very important.
Yeah.
Like what is expected. Yeah. How they are going to be observed, what are the rubrics on based on what. So it's very clear, and really I appreciate. And you have included the SMART, S-M-A-R-T also in your talk very nicely. And also you have included the Bloom's taxonomy, whereby you just said how knowledge to understanding and further how it can be. So it was fantastic, including everything well narrated with that Taj Mahal illustration with Taj Mahal. And I'm sure the teachers will get a better view and it will really help them. But still, I would like my viewers, please post questions if you have any. Even in the recorded session of this, you can post the questions which madam can get back to you later. Madam, if you can just tell, you know, again, though you have explained it well, but I'm sure some viewers may have come later or they may missed it out. So what are the five best ideas, you know, of the instructional management to make it successful?
This is what, again, I say that here the teacher has to work patiently. So to make it successful, she has to contact the parents individually. That she must know that what type of technological tools the parents have and what type of technological tool they will provide to the child. Because sometimes when we contact the parent, they say that they have only one phone and they have gone to work and now they can provide the phone to their child only in the evening. So accordingly, we give them the time slot that, okay, from 6 p.m. to 10 p.m., you can perform this task and the next day you can send this to us. So this is very, very essential, because if we will not be contacting the parents and we will not hear to their problems, so child will not be able to perform the task. If we will just be sending the instructions, okay, do this and send it to me by 2 p.m., the child will be unable to do. So here, so when the child is not present in the classroom, the teacher must have to take care of this part. And secondly, again, I'm telling you that the teacher, she must give simple projects to the child. She must not tell that, okay, prepare the model of Taj Mahal, and the child will be, you know, he will be confused. No, how he has to prepare the model of the Taj Mahal? He doesn't have this thing, that thing. He will tell his parents to provide those things to him, and the parents, they will again complain to the teacher that now they don't have the money to buy all these things for the child. So please, they should not bother us. That's why I told the teachers that they must prepare their videos by collecting the things from nearby surroundings and the things which are available at home. So I could not share those videos and pics because of this technical problem. That's why I'm telling you that most of the things my students, they have prepared with the help of leaves. They were learning phonetic words, and they, you know, they pasted all the pictures, they cut all the leaves, received that video from the teacher and learned that cutting from the teacher and pasted those beautifully, and then they were showing that to me, okay, ma'am, now we have learned this bat, mat, pictures they were showing to me, and they had prepared everything with the help of leaves and simple things which are available at home. So if the teacher will be preparing her own videos by collecting the things which are very, very simple, which are not costly, which are not costing to the parents, so the child will be doing the thing successfully, and the task, the child will be able to accomplish the task. Otherwise, he will not do. True. So this is the one thing. which the teacher has to keep in mind. And then another thing is that she must keep the level of the child in her mind also. So that suppose the class, it is only class UKG class, and what should be my expectations from the child? This she must keep in her mind, and must not expect very high things from her child. And then again I'm telling you that she has to, sometimes she will have to give some more time to the child. The parents reached home and something happened because of the phones of the relatives, and because of these days the parents have become busy on WhatsApp. They could not provide phone to the child, or there was another child in the home and he picked up the phone and he started using, and the teacher started scolding the child that you didn't complete the task. So she has to have a very very amiable and sympathetic attitude towards the child, that why you complete the task, please tell me what was the problem, you please share your problem with me so that I may suggest that why you could not complete your task. So she has to be friendly with the child during these days, instead of talking to him in a commanding way.
True.
And so these are the things which the teacher has to keep in mind to make his her instructional management successful. Anything other, any other question which is in your mind, you can share with me.
No, thank you. I think it's very clear that as you said, first thing is, as you said, that the teachers need to be flexible. Flexible in the sense that they should not be rigid about the submission of any task or project. You're right, because now it's done on digital and virtual platforms, so it's not as easy as it is otherwise. So that is very important thing. Second, you said is age appropriate task is very important. So teacher should keep in mind that when you are giving any kind of task, a project or any assignments, it should be at appropriate to age, so that really the students themselves do without the help of any elders. That is fantastic. And as you said, that they should be empathetic, and they should have that consideration about the child, that what is the child's state at home, whether they have other siblings, parents are involved, they are busy, because parents are also working from home these days. So the availability of resources, and as you said, simple project which is readily available, not with much cost, and they really enjoy doing. So that should be our outcome. Well said, madam. Thank you so much. And there's one
thank you
think
the opportunity
one suggestion or a concern came from one viewer called Ashish Srivastava. The thing is, I feel teachers to cover less syllabus and less is more should be on the philosophy in COVID-19 times. It says that I feel teachers to cover less syllabus. Viewer writes, and less is more should be. She writes, the person writes, I feel teachers to cover less syllabus and less is more should be the philosophy in COVID-19 times. Right now, teachers are running fast. So the parents' concern is that at this moment, teachers are running fast. So it's better to consider on the COVID-19 situation and cover in the less syllabus. Hello? I think madam got disconnected. I think she's disconnected. There's some technical instability, network issues. She's coming back.
It got disconnected.
I understood. It got disconnected. So I just come back to a concern raised by one of the viewers, probably a parent named Ashish Srivastava. The concern is that she says that right now the teachers are running fast with the syllabus, and this is the time when they can cover a less portion of it. You know, so what?
With her. That's because again I say that instead of covering the syllabus, that's because we all know that a child is not present in the classroom and this is not examination oriented instructions. If we will just impart examination oriented instructions, we will not be able to develop the abilities in a child. So we must take care of this thing, that whatever we are doing, so it is to develop the skill in a child, to develop, to bring that desired behavior in a child, and to develop his abilities, and not to cover the syllabus. It is for the, you know, upliftment of the child.
Thank you.
Not examination
oriented. I'm sure the viewer has got it. The viewer who had this concern understood it. Thank you, madam. And I again request the viewers, please do post your questions if you have to ask, and then later after the session, madam can get back to you. Thank you, madam. Thank you for your time. And
thank
I know
you
today you have really had, you know, technically we are helpless at times. So this, but what is important is that we did it, and you did it fantastically with all these technical instability glitches and network instability. Thank you so much. No issues, but maybe some other time we can have it in a better way with some other better topic from you. Thank you so much for coming. Thank you once again, and thank you viewers once again for joining us. Thank you. Have a good day, all of you.